Hello, hello, my beautiful people. Welcome and welcome back again to Gifted Suzy Sue channel. If you are new here, kindly very much welcome in the family and thank you so much for choosing to click onto this video. I'm very much humble and kindly please do me a favor, consider subscribing, smash that red button there which is written subscribe, turn on the notification bell so that anytime I do come up with a new video, you'll be the first one to be notified. For my new subscribers, thank you so much guys for always being there for me. I really appreciate that. For my returning subscribers, my gang gang, I can't forget about you. Thank you so much for always supporting me and always giving me a full support. I'm very much humbled, guys. For that, I am Susan, and as for my channel, I do share my life experience here in Saudi Arabia as a housemaid. And as for today's video, guys, I'm going to share with you some of the mistakes that I did when I was new year in Saudi Arabia. And kama kawaida, without wasting much of your time, allow me to take you straight to my thank you so much again for staying tuned. I appreciate you so much, guys. And one of the mistakes that I did is that I burned my boss's thumb. Yeah, thumb. My boss gave me the thumb and then he told me to go and iron it. So for me, I took the thumb and went in the ironing room to iron the thumb. So when I was ironing it, I burnt it a very big hole. Yeah. And I was like, oh my God, what am I going to say? What am I going to tell him? So I was in deep thoughts. And among the thoughts that the first thought that came to my mind was that just Susan lashed to his wardrobe, pick one of his thumb and come and iron it. And guys, that's what I did. And the good thing is that my boss has got so many thumbs that he even don't know some. Yeah, he don't even some are new. He has never ever worn them. So I quickly lashed to his wardrobe, pick one of the thumb that seemed to be new, and then I went it in the ironing room. And what I did is that because I did not want anyone to realize what I had done, I folded the thumb into a very small size, then I hide it under my arm. For this uniform, our hours are very big, so I put it under my arm and then make sure that no one has seen what I've done. And the good thing also is that in our home back then, we had no CCTVs. So I put it under my arm and then I bend one of my shoulders so that I can hide it, and in that it can't be big here under the arm. I bend my shoulder and then went in the ironing room. I remove it and I iron it and I finish ironing. And good luck on my side is that no one saw me. I was very happy about that. I finished ironing it and then I hung it in the ironing room. So when my boss came out of bathroom, or maybe he was taking a shower, she came in the ironing room, took the thumb and then wore. And the good thing is that he did not realize what I had done. So the one that I burnt, I folded it, put it in a polythene bag and then threw it in the dustbin. And from that day till now, no one has ever realized that that is what I did. But it was a very bad thing of me. I could have speak it out. But sometimes there is a mistake that you do and you feel like, oh no, I can't say, because you don't know what will be the reaction. But you there don't do like me, like the way I did. Yeah. The other mistake I did is that I broke utensils. That day my madam told me to clean the cupboard. Yeah, I can remember very well that day, early that morning. She told me clean the cupboard, remove all the utensils in the entire kitchen and clean them one by one. And that's what I did. So for me, I was removing the utensils from the cupboard and then placing them in the sink to clean. So when I was carrying some plates, I did not saw the water on the floor. I slided and fell down, and all the utensils broke into pieces. And as you know, as usual, they all quick from their rooms to lash and come and see what had happened. So they all came and saw what had happened, and they found me on the floor, and all the plates had broke into pieces. Also, the good thing is that my madam was like, it's okay, no problem. For me, I thought that maybe she will deduct the money from my salary, but she didn't. She said, it's okay, Susan, no problem. It's just a mistake. And I was like, oh my God, may God bless you. Because I know there are some of us whom we are in houses whereby it does not matter what you broke. At the end of the month, you have to be deducted. So you must be very, very careful. So that's why I thank God for the decision my madam did. I did not pay anything. I was very happy for that. Yeah, and on the other hand, I was not hurt. Yeah, I thank God also for that. Yes. So the other mistake that I did is that I slapped the kid. This kid is a nine year old. And this kid, he was used to, when she needs something, it does not matter where I am or what I'm doing, he will come at my back and beat me and then tell me, Susan, I need this, I need this. And I warned the kid several times. I went to an extent of even telling her mom to tell this kid that this behavior of beating me at my back when he needs something, I don't want it. So that early morning, I don't know what was in my mind. Like, you know, guys, this job of ours, sometimes you work while you are in mood, sometimes you are not in mood, but you have to work. It does not matter the mood you are in. It does not matter what, you have to work. So for me, that early morning, I was cleaning the utensils in the sink, and the boy came and, as usual, he beat me at my buttock. And he told me, well, shaking me, Susan, I need this. And I don't know what's lingered in my mind or what happened. I quickly turned back and gave the boy a very hard slap. And even for me, I was like, oh my God, what have I done? And the kid fell on the floor, and he shouted at the top of his voice. Yeah, shouted, and they all came to see what had happened to the boy. As you know, their behavior, well, they don't like their kids crying. They will rush to see what had happened. So they came, and they found the boy on the floor. And for me, I was just holding the super plate and the plate, wondering, what have I done? What have I done? Even I was out of my senses. And when they came, the boy explained to them what had happened, and I also explained to them what I have done. Yeah. So a mom also beat the boy a slight slap at the head, and then he told, I have told you several times not to be doing that. So they gave me what in Kiswahili tunasema msomo. Walinisomea, by the way. They told me, you are not supposed to beat the kids, so. And I was like, it's okay, but tell your kids not to be doing that to me. So I had to apologize to the kid, and also the kid had to apologize to me. And from that day, we have a very good relationship. So for me, I did not mind so much. I was ready for anything that could have happened. And that's when I realized that the Arab kids are also not beaten, because nilisomewa, by the way, nilisomewa. Apana, you are not supposed to do that. You're supposed to report to the kids. But to sincerely speaking, guys, I was not in a good mood. Even for me, I can't tell what I did. Later on, that's when I realized, oh my God, is this what I did? Yeah, but the good thing is that they did not maybe fire me or do anything wrong. They just warned the boy and also warned me not to beat the kids again. Yeah, and we continued with a very good relationship, and I thank God for that. The other mistake that I did is that I was caught singing loud in the room. So for me, guys, for me, in most cases, you find me working while singing. By that time, I was wearing my earphones and then listening to the music. That was what I was doing. So that morning, you know, like for us here, we do work during the day, and during the day it's when they are sleeping. So for me, I did not realize that I was singing in louder. It's the way you put your phones and then you start working and then listening to music. All of a sudden you find yourself shouting at the top of your voice, and the my madam's room was next to the kitchen. So for me, I did not know. And then she was like, "Susan, Susan." And then she woke up and came to see what was happening in the kitchen. And then when she came, I was like, "Oh my God, I just..." Nikastuka tu mara moja, nikashanga, "What have I done?" She told me, "Lower your voice. You are singing too loud." And I was like, "Oh my God, God." I even laughed at myself because I thought I was just listening to the earphone without making noise. And I was making a lot of noise. Yeah. The other mistake that I did is that I was absent-minded. I was absent-minded while being communicated to. Yeah, it was allowed at night when I go to sleep. My madam used to tell me what to do when I woke up early in the morning. So that morning, that evening, I don't know what I was thinking. Sometimes our minds are very far. I know if you're working here in Gav, you know sometimes you just stay at something. You just stay at something even you don't know what you are doing. You just stay at something and maybe someone is speaking to you. So that's what happened that evening. My madam was telling me what I should do the following day. And we began very well talking, but at the middle of the conversation, I just stared at one place, and my madam continued talking, and when she was done, he was like, have you understood? At that time, "Have you understood, Susan?" That's when I came out of my senses. "What?" And she had to repeat what he had told me there before. And I thank God for her. She's very, very understanding. Very understanding. That's why I do love her so much. Yeah, and the other thing is that when I was new, I was always late. Waking up late. Yeah. I was told my official time to wake up was 5:30. And back in my country, I was not used to wake up at 5:30. I was waking up at around 6:50, at 7, that's when I was used to. So for several days, I was waking up late, and when I woke up late, I do things in a quick mood. That's when I realized, even if, what's this time that this person is telling me to wake up, they are not even on, they are in a deep sleep. That's when one day I realized that, and I told my madam, "Please allow me sleep to this time, up to this time, because even if I woke up that at 5:30, I'm doing my duties, and I finish my duty within 3 to 4 hours, and then wait for the evening duty." And she allowed me to be sleeping until 8. Yeah. That's when I woke up at 8 in the morning and then started doing my duties. Yeah. Sometimes that's why I say expressing yourself is a very good thing. Like for me, you see, when I was new here, my madam told me that you are supposed to be waking at 5:30 in the morning. So this 5:30, you woke up, you do all your duties, and maybe within 2 or 3 hours, you are done with your morning duties. And when you are done with your morning duties, like for me, it's very hard for me to go back to bed at that time. Like maybe when you are done, when I'm done with my duty, going back to bed, it's very hard for me. I better just sit down, listen to music, or maybe take a book and start writing something. Yeah, that's me. So that's why I say speaking, it's a way of healing. Because for me, I spoke to my madam, I told her what I think or else what I felt inside me, and she agreed to my issues. So if you too, you are out there, just if you have an issue, speak out. Okay, the other mistake that I did is that I entered men room without even covering my head. Yeah, I was just like that. There before, for me, I was not used to cover my head. I was just working like that without without any problem. I was not even wearing the, is it what are the hijab? I was not wearing them. No, I was just working like a normal Kenyan, maybe only uniforms that I was putting on. So that day, my madam cooked the coffee and then she told me to go put in the main room. So for me, I did not realize that there were men in the room. I'm used to just whereby when you are carrying something, you just go and press in it. Maybe if it's down or maybe on the table, you press on the table and then you move. And that's what I did. I took the coffee and put it in the main room, and I did not realize that they were men, and I was not worried because I'm used to that. So that's when they were like, no, you are not supposed to come here. Yeah. And I was like, wow, what's not happening? So when I went back in the kitchen, my madam told me that, I think my madam had the noise that the men made there. So that's why he asked me, what's not happening? And I explained to her, I've just entered in the room and pressed the coffee down. And then they said, no, la, la, la. Yeah, so that's when my madam told me, for here, our culture does not allow that thing to happen. Men and women don't mix. I just told you, just go and press it down. They will, down on the door, they will pick it. And to be sincere, my madam did not tell me that I place it down, they will pick. No, I just did it in a Kenyan way, whereby you just work as a good helper, you just pick your coffee and go and give them. That's what I did. And from that, that's when I realized that for here, men and women, they don't interact. They do their things in a separate way. And the worst thing is that for me, even I had not covered myself, I had not worn that hijab, I did not wear it at all. Yeah, so for them, maybe it was a very awkward thing. It was a very awkward to them, and even to me, it was also a very awkward thing because I did not know anything. I was just acting like a good servant to the bosses. Yeah. Another mistake that I did is that I bleached the clothes. I was given Clorox and soap to go and clean the clothes. So for me, I did not know that Clorox was acting like a jerk. No. I placed all the clothes in the washing machine. I put the soap and also I added on top the Clorox. But at the back of my mind, I thought that Clorox was acting like a Star Soft. Like a Star Soft. Although their smell, the Clorox smell and the Star Soft smell is quite different. But at the back of my mind, that's what I think, because I was not explained to what's the meaning of this, or else what's the use of this Clorox. So for me, I put the clothes and also hand soap on the Clorox and then closed my machine and waited them to finish cleaning. So when they were done, I went to remove the clothes. What got me, guys? I was like, oh my God, what have I done? All the clothes were in two colors. If it's white, it's green with a white. Yani, they were bleached, all of them. And I told my madam, and oh, yes, she made a lot of noise. What have you done? What? And I was like, you did not tell me what's the use of this Clorox, so stop complaining. Yeah. She argued a lot, but the good luck, it's at the end of all. For me, I'm very quick to apologize. I'm very quick. I think I'm allergic to that. When I do a small mistake, I'm very sorry. And that's all. And that's what I did. Even if she was left there complaining, that's her own issue. For me, I've done my part. I did not know. Even God knows that I did not know the use of the Clorox. Yeah, and I also said sorry for that. And she said, it's okay, but... She was like, so okay, but, and I had nothing to do, yeah. And they just threw all the clothes, yeah. That's what I did. Thank you so much, guys, for being with me. I really appreciate you so much. And as for that, I do mark the end of my today's video, guys. I know You too, there, you are watching me. You've ever done a mistake? Yes, you've ever done. If at all you've been in a new place or maybe in a new environment that you're not used to, I'm very sure that there is something that you did contrary with what maybe they expected you to do or how things are done over there. Kindly drop it in the commenting section and I will be so glad. Also, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to share with your friends and also like the video. And until we meet next time, guys, I really appreciate you so much. And kindly continue subscribing, continue turning on the notification bell so that anytime I do come up with a new video, you'll be the first one to be notified. I love you so much, guys, and let me.